Hello. This is the 22nd consecutive year that I've asked members of the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons for their vote to fix the junk pet food fraud. Yes, all those years ago, we realised it was a major, major problem that our pets, the cats, dogs and ferrets under our care were suffering terribly as a result of the monotonous junk food diet that they were forced to consume. They had rotten mouths, they were obese, and their liver and kidneys and immune systems all started to collapse under the load. Something needed to be done, and one of the things to do was to stand for election and seek the profession's concurrence with the need to do something about it. Last year, almost 500 vets voted to fix the junk pet food fraud. So there's a couple of questions here now put before us. One was, is the RCVS a first-rate regulator? Well, I think the evidence is quite clear. Faced with the biggest problem they could ever possibly imagine, they've buried their heads in the sand. No, they are not the first-rate regulator that they need to be. What about vested conflict of interest? Establishment. And so they're there to support the status quo. But the status quo is not good enough. Our pets deserve better. Our pet owners absolutely depend on us to do the right thing by them. So please, as a voter, please consider the slogans on this wall behind me. Please also consider all the extra information you'll find at rawmeatybones.com. And then once you've had a look at that, had a look at all the videos, looked at all the papers, look at all the testimonials, please, I implore you, vote for a better way.